Hello everybody. In this video, I'm going to show you how to turn a test bank that might be on a Word document into a Canvas test bank using this handy Canvas quiz converter from San Diego State University. And I'll put the link to this in the description, but you can also Google Canvas quiz converter San Diego State and it'll pop up. And this tool is pretty good, but it does take some formatting before this will work. I do like clicking this link here that says this extended document, because that's going to give you examples of how to format the questions. And it has every kind of question you can think of here. And I just want you to note, you see how it says, like, for this multiple choice, it has the number one with a period and then a space, then the question. And then the choices, A, B, C, D, etc., those have brackets. So that's one thing that you have to change. So if you have periods after A, B, C, you have to change those to brackets. So these are just kind of the formatting things that you have to be aware of. If you want feedback, you need to add three ellipses with the space and then the feedback for each question or each answer. And all those instructions are on this page, so it's not too daunting of a task. So let's go over to my test bank here, which is in Word. This is for OpenStax World History book that just came out. And I just want to put all these questions into Canvas so I can make quizzes and stuff. So the first step is you open the Word document, and then you're going to save it as a plain text file. So in Word, you're going to click File, Save As, and here you can rename it if you want, and then also take a note where it's going to save the file to. And the important thing is file format. You're going to change it from DOCX to plain text, which is .txt, and then click Save. And then there's another step here. You're going to choose Other Encoding, and you're going to select Unicode UTF-8. And then click OK. So that saved this file as a plain text document. Now I have to open that plain text document, so that's why it's a good idea to know where your files are being saved to. So for this one, it's saved to my desktop in my World History Text Bank folder, and this one I'm working on is Chapter 7, so it retained the same name, but it's now a text document. And I can just tell just by the icon next to the title there. So I'll go ahead and double click on this. And I'm gonna open it up. And you can see the print's very small. So I'm gonna use the keyboard shortcut of Control plus on my keyboard, Command plus if you're on a Mac, and that'll just zoom it up. And basically you wanna delete anything extraneous. So this title of the test bank, review questions where it says multiple choice, all that has to kind of disappear. Also, the little asterisks shouldn't be to the right of the correct answer. We're going to remove that and put it on the left. So now D is still the correct answer. And then you can see I need to change the little periods after A, B, C, D. The quickest way to do that is to do a find and replace. So I'm going to copy A period space and then do a Control F on my keyboard, or a Command F if you're on a Mac. And then I'm going to paste in that A period space, and you'll see it's highlighted every single one on the test bank. And then I can click the little replace checkbox here, and I can replace that with A bracket space. So now that's going to go ahead and replace them all. I could have done this in the actual Word document. That's just a preference of mine to do it in the text document. You also want to be careful when using find and replace, because you might have it'd be strange, but you might have a sentence that ends in A dot period. It's more common with D, actually, because, like, if there was a period after the word worked, let's say, period, it would highlight that and it might change it. It might replace it with a bracket. So just be aware, you might want to proofread it after you've done all these replacements. So I'm going to go ahead and replace all of them, and you can see it automatically did that. And I'll do the same for B, C, and D. And just as a nice quick way to look for if there's any mistakes, I'm going to do the find for the D bracket now. And I'm just going to scroll through my test bank file here and look if that D is on the in the middle. Ah, and here it looks okay. But this fill in the blank question here, you can see it ended in the household. So I want to change that D back to what it was. And let's see, here's another one where they have a household D, should be that. So you can see I'm just fixing these. This is feedback on essay questions at the bottom here. Now it looks like it's done. And because this is a demo, I'm only going to do the multiple choice questions on this test bank. Sometimes you'll find it's easier to separate these test banks by category. So multiple choice should be its own test bank in Canvas, and essay questions, fill in the blanks, those can be their own separate test banks. And that way you don't have to worry about mixing in a bunch of essay questions in a test. Maybe you only want to select one specific essay question. You don't want it to randomly select more than one for the test. So I'm going to go ahead and fix the rest of this test with the asterisk, put that to the left of the correct answer, and we'll come back when it's time to upload this. Okay, so I finished formatting these questions, so you can see I have the asterisk to the left of the correct answer in the multiple choice, and I fixed any misspellings. You can see I've created the true false. Here's a good example, question number 7, where I've put feedback after the true answer. So the correct answer here is false, but if the student answers true, it will provide them this feedback that I've listed right under the true choice with the three dots here, and then a space, and then the feedback. I've also left this mistake here on purpose, just to see if it detects it, just for fun. And then here is a different type of question. This is called an identify question, where it's very similar to a multiple choice, but you have the square brackets next to the choices, and then you have the correct answer marked with an asterisk inside of the square brackets. You can see I've also, here's another mistake that I'm leaving in on purpose. I left this difficulty. These are all things that normally you would have to remove in your file to clean it up before uploading it. Here's some fill in the blanks. So these ones, you just have the question, and then the answer for the blank is below the question with the little asterisk, and so here it is. You can also do multiple answers here. If you look at that formatting file down below, here is a good example of a fill in the blank where they've given multiple choices. So if a student wrote Santa for who lives in the North Pole, they would get it right. But if they also wrote Santa Claus, they would also get it right. And same with these other choices here. So this is just a way to make sure that even though students might all have the correct answer, they can write it differently and it would still elicit a correct answer. For that reason, I kind of steer clear of fill in the blanks, just because I know any little spelling mistake might mess up if a student gets it right or wrong. But anyways, just an example, I'm leaving them in here. So here is my corrected formatted text file. I'm going to save it. And then we'll go to the converter here. And here it is. So to drop the file here, you can drag and drop it, or you can click on that empty space and then find that file. So I know these are in my desktop here in this folder. Here it is, chapter 7, and it's a plain text document. So I'm going to open it and let's see what happens. So here it's found an error, and it says syntax error unexpected text or incorrect indentation for a wrapped paragraph, and it gives the quotation answer false. So I have a feeling that's the one I left in there. So if we go in here, so let's find that mistake. We're going to do a control find and answer false. There it is on question 7. So yeah, this was an extra line that I left in from the publisher. I'm going to delete it and I'll save it again. And we'll try this again. So I'm going to refresh this page to see if it'll give us... Nope, we have to go back and then try it again. Drop file here, click and upload. And now it's saying there's some difficulty, difficult. So I left that text in there as well. Let's go back to the file, find difficulty. And there it is there. So after I remove this and the extra space, now it should work. I'm going to save it again. We'll go back to the quiz converter. And this time it should work. Nope, it found a problem. Missing white space after an asterisk. On line 90, and line 90 doesn't really help because you sort of would have to count the lines down to 90. But I'm gonna look for missing white space. Maybe you need a space for these fill in the blanks. Let's see. Okay, hopefully that'll fix that issue. And we'll upload it. Ah, now it worked. So you can see it downloads it to my computer as a zip file, which will have the same title as the text document with the .zip at the end. And if we look in the Finder, I can see it's gone to my downloads folder here. So now I can go into Canvas, and I'm going to import it into Canvas. So now I go to Settings, I'm going to go to Import Course Content. I'm going to choose QTI.zip file. And then we're just moving down, so we're going to go Choose File, go to my Downloads folder, and there it is, my Chapter 7, and I'm going to open it up. And that'll attach it inside of Canvas here. And now I can click on Import. And that's complete. So now I can go into Quizzes. And it's always going to create a quiz that contains all of the questions that are in those files that you've just imported. So don't forget to delete these, because you definitely don't want... Normally, you don't want a quiz that has every single question in a test bank. So just keep in mind you want to do that. And the next step is to go into the test bank itself. So you're going to click on the three dots next to plus quiz on the right and select Manage Question Banks. And you can see I've done a whole bunch here, but Chapter 7 is down here, and they title it just Quiz. So you want to change that title. Especially if you're doing multiple chapters. So this is going to be, and I'm going to just copy the title from this one, and I'm going to rename it Chapter 7 Multiple Choice and True False. Okay. And then I'm going to move, because I did put some fill in the blank questions in here, I'm going to make a separate quiz bank and move the fill-in-the-blank questions into it. So I'm going to copy the fill-in-the-blank title. I'm going to click Add Question Bank. I'm going to make my new one and title it Chapter 7 Fill-in-the-blank. I'm going to go back into that one that has all my questions. I'm going to select Move Multiple Questions. And then I'm going to scroll down and find the ones that have the fill-in-the-blank, so I can tell just because I know that this is a blank here. So I'm going to check those off, and I know it's the last five at the end or so. And then, so I've checked the ones I want to move. I'm going to scroll down and find my chapter 7 fill in the blank bank and then move those questions there. So now I have all my multiple choice and true false in this bank. And then if I go to my banks, I now have the 5 questions that are fill in the blanks in my fill in the blank test bank. So that's it. I'm going to now make a different one for the essay questions and keep going until I've got all my test banks inside a Canvas, and then I can make my quizzes from them. That's it. Thanks for watching.